Today, I'm going to show you how to add background music in Premiere Pro to your video files. We're also going to solve a problem of an audio clip that is way shorter or longer than your video track, and that's where Adobe Audition comes in. So this is actually really simple. We're going to jump right in. Here's a project that I had worked on previously. It's one of my YouTube videos. It is a Photoshop template video. I want to add some background music here to this video now. So in your project, if you haven't already, import your favorite audio clip. I'm going to come up here to File, Import, and bring in this clip here. So after you have your clip in your project window, so now I'm going to double click on my clip and you see it up here in the source window. So if you want to edit it, maybe you want to cut off any portion of it, you can of course mark your endpoints, I for endpoint, O for out point. So up here where my cursor is, says drag audio only. Make sure you're dragging from there to your timeline. That's one way you can do it. Or from your project window, you could just drag your clip onto the timeline. And of course, you can edit it any way you want here. You can hit a C, and that's a razor tool, and you can chop it up however you like. But I want to bring in the whole clip. And as I resize the clips, you can see the waveform. Already you can see that the audio on the clip that I brought in is pretty high. So we'll take care of that later. But the clip I brought in is 2 minutes and 46 seconds. And my timeline is 13 minutes and 13 seconds. What I want to do is I want to make that whole clip go all the way across my timeline. Now, this is the old way. I would have to lock a clip. Like in this case, I would have to lock the audio clip above it. Say Command C, bring my playhead over and say Command V, and it pasted it in. But then I would have to move the clip up to the last clip. And I would have to keep on doing that and guess. But what we're going to do is let Adobe Audition take it from here, and it's going to do everything automatic for us. Let's see how that works. So now we're going to select our new audio clip, right click, and say Edit Clip in Adobe Audition. And so now we're going to come up here to the top and click on Multitrack. And we're going to name our session and click OK. And now from this window up on the upper left on the top, drag your clip onto the top track. And I'm going to move this over. And now I'm going to go over to the properties and click Enable Remix. And the clip is analyzing. And we're going to come over here to Target Duration. And it says that the clip is 2 minutes and 46 seconds. I'm going to change this to something like 13 minutes and 13 seconds. And it is applying the remix. And Audition has mixed that clip. It has extended it. Then we can come up here to File, Export, Export to Adobe Premiere Pro. And all these settings are good unless there's another place you want to save this particular file here, but you can take a default and make sure it says Open in Adobe Premiere Pro, this checkbox right here, and say Export. Once back into Adobe Premiere Pro, you can select where you want to copy the new track. And I'm going to say Audio 3 and say OK. Now I'm going to get rid of the previous audio track. The one was too short. I'm just going to delete that. And I'm going to move the new audio track up. And I'm going to slide over and see actually how it did over here on the end. I'm going to slice this off at the end here. I'm going to hit C and cut that clip right there. And now we're all even. If you're getting value out of this so far, hit that like button. So now let's make some adjustments to that audio track. First of all, it's too loud. We're going to do some more automatic adjustments here. We're going to use the Essential Sound panel. If you don't see the Essential Sound panel, just come up to Window and select it if it is not checked. So with the new audio track selected, I am going to click on Music in the Essential Sound panel. Well, first I want to play a little bit of it.
Today we're going to take a look at using templates in Photoshop. You're going to see how we can customize them.
So obviously the music is way too loud, and the dialogue that's going on in the tutorial is being drowned out by this new background music. So if I come over here to the loudness, click on that, there's something called auto match. So if you click on that and look at the new waveform of the audio clip, you're going to see or the waveform go down. We'll play a little bit more of it here.
We're going to take a look at using templates in Photoshop. You're going to see how we can customize them.
So that's a lot better. You want to adjust it a little bit. You want to raise that level or lower it a little bit. You can come down here further in the music panel and click on level. You can bring it down or up, to whatever suits your taste. Let's say, around 5 dB, minus 5 dB, and play it again.
For your own work. Plus, we're gonna take a look at how you can use smart objects
so
in Photoshop.
That's a lot better. And then you can go to the end of your clip. Let's put a transition on the end of this audio clip that we just brought in. I'm gonna put an exponential fade on that end of that clip. So I'm gonna drag that onto my new audio clip. And what you can also do is cut that clip right at the end there. And independently, if you wanted to bring the audio back up with that clip selected, you can bring your audio level back up at the very end. If you want to know more about Adobe Premiere Pro, click or tap on one of the videos on the screen now. If you haven't already, subscribe, like, and share this video. Thanks for watching, and remember, it's never too late to learn. See you in the next video.